Hey people, welcome to Tots and Moms. My name is Kavita and in today's video we'll talk about white patches which you often see on kids' skin, and at that age when they are going to school it is very common. So in this video we'll try and understand what is it, why does it occur, is there a home remedy or when to visit doctor, all the details relatively. And please do watch the video till the end. If you are watching a video on my channel for the very first time, please subscribe. I am sure if you have come here on this channel for this topic, you have many more questions related to child care, baby care, and we also share videos on parenting, postpartum care. So do consider subscribing. And if you have been watching my videos, if you have subscribed to my channel and not getting notification, it is merely because you wouldn't have clicked that bell icon. So please go and click that bell icon so that you keep getting notification and updates as and when we post any new video. Let's dive right in. What are these white patches? These are not permanent but temporary, and there is no need to compare it with leucoderma or vitiligo. This is a skin condition called as pityriasis alba, and this is very common in kids of this age, especially 3 to 16 years. And it comes on face majorly, and it can come on their back, shoulder, arms as well. And it is whitish, flaky, or sometimes even reddish, a slight discoloration over the skin. And this is harmless, and it is proven that it is harmless, but it is very common and hence most of them worry, and hence this video. Okay, now how to get rid of these patches? Now, it's harmless, but it is something that kids wouldn't like because they are conscious, obviously, and when their friends ask, they wouldn't be comfortable. So they want to get rid of it, and even you. So let me tell you, simple things. We need to be healthy inside out. So first you need to understand if your child is on a healthy diet. It is very common that kids are choosy, picky and fuzzy, and hence they avoid eating vegetables or fruit sometimes. It's good if your child is on a healthy diet. If not, please try and include these, because this is how they get the vitamin C, D, E, especially the calcium which is required to keep their skin healthy. And they will be playing outside a lot, and when there is a lot of exposure to sunlight, it may increase and spread as well. So it's not contagious, but it's good to use sunscreen with broader spectrum, like 30 SPF is good. Let them apply a layer of sunscreen before they go out. Also, let them keep their skin moisturized. Non-scented emollients or creams are good. If you can use baby cream or moisturizer, that would be great, because they are with the least chemicals possible. And deworming is better, because at this age, it's good to keep their gut healthy, and every 6 months once you can check if that is the case, and it helps. It's not proven, nothing is proven, because I forgot to tell you, there is no cause which is proven that this is the reason why kids get white patches. And hence these are certain observations which have been helping kids for a longer time. So do this, and I'm sure this should help. These white patches are harmless and they subside on their own. Gradually, you need to just give them time. And in case you are observing it a lot, and when is it that you need to go to a doctor? Let me tell you. At first, if there is a severe itching that the child is not able to bear, then yes. And then if you see discoloration, if it is changing color to red and then hue, then it is something which is which needs some attention. And there is loss of sensitivity in that area, or if the patches are just increasing, then these are chances that you should not take risk. Maybe that is something else, and hence please take your child to doctor. And this was a knowledge on one topic which we usually fret, and there are plenty of such things that only knowledge can help us. Not for everything we need to go to a doctor. So there are a lot of videos on my channel which can be helpful, and if you want to know about something similar, do comment. I shall try to make a video on that. And check all our videos in case you haven't checked yet. There are plenty already in our playlist. I'll see you soon in yet another video. In our next section, I'll be talking about a simple topic, whether it's a myth or truth that pregnant women should not shift houses during that time. So check that and subscribe bell icon so that you get a notification.